In one of my most recent videos, I was showing off the new font size calculator I came up with, and down in the comments of that video, I had several people that were new to Clamp wondering what else it would be useful for. So I thought I would make a video on using Clamp for section padding, which is one of the use cases where I think Clamp really shines. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can go from using static pixel values for your desktop, tablet, and mobile breakpoints, and put in one Clamp function that will automatically scale depending on the device size. It's one of those things that not only saves time, but I think ends up making a better product because instead of having static jumps or stair steps for all your sizes, it just smoothly transitions from one to the other. So let's take a look at how it's done. So I'm going to set up kind of an ugly section here, but just really more for demonstration purposes. So I'm just going to add a container here. We'll go into our settings and I'm going to give it a dark background color. And then inside of it, I'm going to use this button here to create an inner container, which will just constrain everything to my website's content width. And I'm going to go ahead and give that a background color here too, just so we can see how it's all working. Now, as kind of a default starting place on this outer container, I will usually go in here into my spacing and do 80 pixels of top padding and then 24 on the left and right. And this to me is a pretty good default section padding. It works well in a lot of cases. Of course, sometimes you need more, sometimes you need less, but this is a good starting point. Of course, when we go down into our mobile responsive settings and we go to our tablet here, this still looks okay. But when we get down all the way to our mobile version here, I think these proportions look off. There's a little bit too much spacing on the left and right. For me, 24 pixels is too much on a mobile phone. I like 16, which is a little bit tighter. And then that leaves a huge gap here at the top and the bottom, and something about the proportions just don't look right. So a lot of times what I'll do is just go in here into mobile. Instead of that 80 we had originally, I might do something more like 48 and then 16 on the left and right. And here, something like this looks a little bit more in proportion to what we had when we were back on our desktop setting. Now, going through and setting all those up one by one is a definite pain in the butt, so you want to do all of this with classes. However, there's no real reason to use pixels in these situations. Clamp actually does all of this beautifully because it's going to automatically respond smoothly based on the user's viewport size. So let's go ahead and start over with a new section here. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of what we had. I'm going to add a container here. And again, I'm just going to go ahead and give it a dark background so we can see what we're doing. We'll add our inner container here and again, give it a bright color just so we can see our spacing here. Now for this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a class called section --d for default, and I'll go ahead and hit create. We'll start blank because I don't want to move any of those colors over onto my section, and we'll open up our spacing here. Now what I want to do instead of putting raw pixel values in here is use clamp functions. So if we go to this clamp calculator, which I will of course link down in the description below, we can set our minimum size, our maximum size. These are going to be the sizes for our padding. We set our minimum viewport and our maximum viewport, and then we can leave this root font size and viewport units alone, and it's going to spit out a clamp function for us. So let's start with that block padding, the padding on the top and the bottom. So we know at a minimum size, I wanted to go all the way down to 48 pixels, but on a maximum size, I wanted it to be all the way up at 80. Now, as far as the viewport minimum and maximum, this is really up to your preference. For me, I like it to stop shrinking when we get down to about 420 pixels. That's a fairly large cell phone size, but it's not going to scale down smaller and smaller if somebody's using a really small phone. For the maximum viewport, I usually try to match this somewhere around whatever the content width of my website is. 1280 is kind of my default for my content width, so we'll just start with that, and then we'll go ahead and hit calculate. So here we got a clamp function that goes here from 3rem, which is our 48 pixels, and we'll scale all the way up to 5rem, which is our 80 pixels here. So I can just grab all of this and copy it to my clipboard. We'll go back into GenerateBlocks here and in spacing, making sure we're still inside of this class. We'll go ahead and paste in that clamp value for both the top and bottom padding on our section here. Now we can go back to the calculator here and worry about our inline padding, which is the left and right. At the minimum on small cell phones, I want it to be 16, and the maximum, I want it to be 24. And we can leave these just like they were before and go ahead and hit calculate. Now I'll go ahead and copy this, and we can paste it here into the left and right. And now as we go through our responsive settings here, making sure we're able to click through to those, it's going to go ahead and automatically scale these down proportionately. It's a little bit easier to see here if we go onto the front end of the website. Since our yellow in the middle doesn't have any size. We're gonna have to give it a size here. So let's go back to our desktop. We'll go into our sizing and we'll just say it has a minimum height of 500 pixels just so we have something to work with inside there. Go ahead and refresh this page now and we'll jump into the inspector. So you can see here, this is kind of mimicking a really, really wide screen. I'm actually zoomed out quite a bit and I have my browser opened up to like 3,800 pixels wide. Nothing's gonna move until we get down to right at the content width of the website. You can see this is gonna stick at our 24 pixels and then it's just gonna scroll smaller and smaller and smaller until we get down to our minimum breakpoint, which happens right around 420. Let me go ahead and zoom in to 100% here. And we see there's about 48 pixels of space here at the top and the bottom. In fact, there's probably exactly 48 pixels and 16 on the left and right. But as we get bigger, we can see that that padding has increased. Now, if I go in here to the section and we go into our computed here, we can see the padding bottom and the padding left and right, and then the padding top. Right now, since we're above that 1280 pixels, we're maxed out at 80 pixels top and bottom padding and 24 left and right. But as we scroll down here, you can see that top and bottom padding as well as the inline padding here is shrinking until we get all the way down into that 420 pixels where it's gonna lock in at 48 pixels of top and bottom padding and 16 of left and right. So a clamp function does a really good job of making all of this responsive by default, so you don't have to go set all these individual breakpoints. Now what I'll typically do is set up a section D for my default sections, and then I can set up some smaller and larger variants of that. So let's go ahead and just get rid of this class for now. I'm gonna save this and refresh. Sometimes the builder kind of mucks up here. It's not actually going full width anymore. So once we refresh, we get that back. So let's work on a larger section. So if we go in here and we go to section, and I'm gonna type --L for large, we'll go ahead and hit create. We're gonna start completely blank here and we'll go into our spacing. Now we still have this open for our left and right. That's not gonna change on any of these sections. We wanna keep that same padding consistent across the website. So I'll just go ahead and copy that value again and we'll paste it in here for our inline padding. Now before for this minimum size and maximum size, we did 48 and 80 for our default section. Now since we're doing a larger section, we need to go bigger. So maybe on this one, we go with something like 60 and 120. And we can go ahead and hit calculate here and we get our new clamp value. So we'll go ahead and copy that, go back into generate blocks and we can paste it in here for our top and bottom padding. So now if I just duplicate this section here, we get rid of this large class and we put in our section default. You can see this top one here has quite a bit more padding than the bottom one here. In fact, let me just change these colors so it's a little bit more obvious. We'll go with blue here and we'll save this and go take a look on the front end. So now when I refresh here, you can see our large section here has more padding than our default section. Of course, you might want also an extra large and then go smaller to a small and an extra small where you tighten up that padding for much smaller sections that don't need as much breathing room. In my most recent starter site, I set up these section classes for extra large, large, default, small, and extra small. So I have a nice little range of section paddings to start out with. This can be really useful to just start building out things pretty quickly. It's really nice if you don't have an existing design that you're needing to match pixel for pixel, but even when I'm designing something in Figma, I'm getting kind of a general idea of what I want that spacing to be, but it's when I actually go to develop it that I really dial those things in and make sure that they're consistent across the whole website. If you use a convention like this where you have four or five different sizes, you can really make things consistent, and the clamp function makes sure that everything is mobile responsive out of the gate, which saves you a lot of time in the long run. I can't tell you how many times I've found sites where I went and set those padding settings on desktop, but never bothered to go do it on mobile. So there's some sections that have the mobile padding and some that don't. So you can see they kind of jump back and forth as you scroll down the page. Obviously that's a failure on my part, but the clamp function will save you from those scenarios since it automatically responds depending on the device size. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and got something out of it. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up. And if you want to make sure to catch the next one, then hit subscribe and we'll see you then.